to the updates from new community networks. We did not hear. Actually, we'll have one more update from Tunapanda later. The new ones in this case will be Shikamoto. So, can we?
Said in India is that you have a tower and you can't see the structure because it's full.
That makes it efficient.
Thank you. So I am from Media Monitoring Africa, here to talk about our Shikamoto project. I'm joined by my colleague Billy over there, who is going to help me with any of the technical issues that you might have questions about. But I'm going to start with giving you a bit of a background of who MMA is, because we're not your usual community network type organization. So just to explain the link with that, and then go into explaining what Shikamoto is and what we're doing. So Media Monitoring Africa is a non-benefit trust. So an NGO established in 1993 to monitor South Africa's first democratic elections. To monitor the media coverage of the elections. And since then, we have monitored a massive range of different research projects, different media-related issues, and we also directly engage with various media owners, houses, government, civil society, and, of course, citizens. So, in South Africa, MMA is one of the only independent organizations that does the sort of work that we do using the frameworks and the methodologies that we do. And in all of our work, we seek to demonstrate leadership, creativity, and a progressive approach to meet the changing needs of the media environment. So, then just more broadly, MMA's vision is a just and fair society empowered by free, responsible, and quality media. And we do this through a human rights-based approach, which aims to promote the development of media that is transparent, diverse, ethical, and accountable to its audiences, promote the critical and constructive communication by the powerful, and then as well as informed, engaged, and connected citizenry. And for us, this is where the community network aspect of it comes in, where our goal with this is to help build an informed and engaged citizenry, which we realize can't be achieved without access to information. And with access to information, we see that the internet should be, or is considered as a facilitative right, which is therefore a tool for effective participation and democratization. Having said that, we then need to ensure that everyone is connected to the internet, and that the internet stays and remains and increasingly is a tool for equality. We also ranging issues that need to be addressed, but using technology as a means for this. So, as you might realize, for us, it's not necessarily just about the infrastructure of the community networks, but rather a more broader objective of content issues and the actual access to communication itself. So, what is Shikimoto then? There are three different elements to Shikimoto. The one is the actual local network itself, and with that comes Shikajava and Shikashare. Now, we're going to be going into a lot more detail about Shikashare and Shikajava tomorrow in the panel discussion. We'll address some of the more technical aspects of that and go into why we're doing those elements. So, this is just an overview of the entire network itself. So, with Shikimoto comes unlimited free text messages, the ability to share pictures, files, and documents. There's a community-driven website that is on the network, and through this you're able to post adverts, look at latest news, events in the community, or at least this is what we've experienced the website to be at the moment. There is also the ability to access whitelisted websites, and then through Shikashare, the sharing and reselling of data for more affordable access to the internet. And there's a large focus on the issue of skills development in the community, as well as the community ownership of the network. We realize that these two objectives come hand in hand with coming in and working with community networks, that the issues of digital literacy and the skills development, as well as empowering communities to take ownership of these networks. So I'm going to just touch on a bit of the tech side of this, which, like I said, I'm really no expert on this side of it. But essentially it's made up of a mesh network of a router, Raspberry Pis, base nodes, and a master node. And at the moment we're using the Ubiquiti Pico nodes. The current system extends 3 to 5 kilometers in range, with the base nodes being placed approximately 500 meters apart from one another. With the Shikashare, although it's an element of the system, there are variations in the hardware that come with that that system. But like I said, we'll go into more about that tomorrow. So there are three different sites at the moment where Shikashare is active and working. It's all based in Johannesburg and predominantly on the East Rand of Johannesburg. And this has purely been because of already existing projects where we've been able to partner and work with and also seen the need of Shikimoto in these communities. So the one which are the longest running site is in a community called Villa Lisa near Vosloorus on the East Rand of Johannesburg. And it's an interesting project because it's in an ECD center, early childhood development, where they've used the system to communicate with parents and implement a digital parenting program across the network. They've also implemented a digital database where the school was previously using purely paper-based reporting and paper-based admin, finances and admin, and they've now moved over to a digital database which they're able to access and share over the network, and they're changing the way that the school is operating on that level. The other site is in Davyton. The other two sites are in Davyton, also on the East Rand of Johannesburg, and it's based at a community centre where there's a lot of youth development work happening there. So they're using the Shikimoto system, also with community media, community radio, community TV. They're using the system to promote their work, promote their local news, and so on. So, as not coming from a background of working community networks, as Media Monitoring Africa, we've obviously, you know, learned a lot about the process and experienced various challenges in coming into working in this space. But having those challenges has given space many opportunities and areas where we see learning taking place as well. So I think this is also just reiterating a lot of the issues that we've been speaking about today already. And I think what is a bit of an affirmation is that a lot of these challenges are being experienced, but they're very common challenges being experienced in various projects. One, the lack of electricity and unreliable connections in electricity. So I'm really interested in the sessions that later on the solar power and the battery operated equipment. It's one of the areas that we're struggling with. Also, that the systems need to be shaped to the needs of the community. We couldn't just go in and say, well, this is our idea, this is great, and implement it. It really was a collaboration with the various partners within the community, seeing what their needs are. And the content of Shipping Water, interestingly, has changed according to the communities themselves. So whereas Benelisa is focused on the ECD side of things, Davidson is focused on youth development, and so the content is very different on both sides. Issues of digital literacy. And not only issues of digital literacy when it comes to an awareness of internet and the need for internet and the need for communication, but also just using the hardware. An example was with Benelisa, when looking at how to shape Shipping Water for the needs of the centre, what we thought was going to be an issue turned out not to be, where the centre had the equipment, they had laptops, they had computer systems, but they hadn't been trained and skills developed in that sense to actually use the equipment. So that for us was also an interesting aspect. So we came in with the database with the equipment already existing and managed to find a connection there. Also spoken about it a bit earlier, the licensing and regulation issues. So because Shipping Water is a local network at the moment without direct access to external services, there aren't really any licensing issues with that. Where he's experiencing some, I'd say, challenges is the share component, where it's dealing with the selling and sharing of data, which we're also going to touch on a bit more tomorrow, and that we're having to deal with the ICASIC, South African regulatory body. So we're waiting to see the outcome of that. And also, obviously, the cost of access. But with the issue of the cost of access, this is where we really see Shikashare taking off, because that is directly dealing with the costs of data and the costs of the communication. Because again, we as MMA went in going, this is amazing, the mesh network is what appears to be solving an issue. But then the community was saying, well, this is great, this is something we would love to use, but we're still dealing with the issue of the cost of communication. So that's also been a really interesting journey, which we'll go into more detail tomorrow. So that was just a very brief overview of what we're doing with Shipping Water. And I'll be very happy to chat to you with any further information or questions about that.